What's going on, guys, and welcome back to another video, and welcome to your stimulus check update, stimulus package, and infrastructure update and daily news report for Tuesday, October 5th. Now, I've been getting a lot of questions over the past few days about a $1,500 stimulus check and an $1,800 stimulus check. So I'm going to address that in today's video. We're also gonna dive into the possibility of a US recession. Gonna give you some daily news regarding the upcoming vaccines and booster shots. Got to talk about the debt ceiling news. And obviously I'm gonna address the stimulus update for today. So if you have any questions whatsoever, please ask your questions down in the comment section below. Also, if you enjoy these daily uploads, could you do me a favor? Go ahead, hit that like button. It really does help out the channel. And also consider subscribing so you never miss an update. But let's get into the news for today. First, I want to start off by addressing the news of a new $1,500 and $1,800 stimulus check. Where is that coming from? Well, here's what we know. These are not new. This is the mainstream media, and these are people on social media taking the ideas that lawmakers are giving them and pretty much crafting their own idea from it. Here's what I mean. Lawmakers have stated that they are open to the idea of cutting certain bills in half, cutting down on their spending. Here's what I mean. Instead of spending $3.5 trillion over 10 years, maybe we only spend about $2 trillion over just 5 years. And so essentially, it's the exact same amount of money that's going out every single year. We're just cutting everything down by about 50%. Well, lawmakers have said that they're open to this idea, and one of those provisions would be the child tax credit payments, which currently we get $3,000 per year, which actually comes out to $250 per month for a child between the ages of 6 and 17, or we get $3,600 per year, which is $300 per month for a child between 0 and 5. So what we're actually seeing is mainstream media is taking these ideas, flipping the words, and making it seem like we're either gonna get a $1,500 stimulus check or an $1,800 stimulus check, when in reality, lawmakers are still discussing either the $3,000 child tax credit payment and extending that, and extending the $3,600 child tax credit payment and extending that one as well, okay? The difference though, and this is where people are getting confused, is because everyone keeps throwing out these different numbers. Here's what you need to keep in mind. Lawmakers are talking about, instead of going for 4 years of the child tax credit payments, okay, and go from anywhere from, what is that, 4 years times three, $12,000 for 4 years, they're considering actually bringing that down. And so instead of 4 years of extending the bill, let's just extend it for 2 years. And so essentially they're not cutting the child tax credit payments in half. It's not a new stimulus check, okay? It's the exact same checks that have been coming out, the exact same payments, but it's making a lot of people very confused. So I wanted to address that first off, because I know I've been getting a lot of questions as to why am I not addressing the new $1,500 and $1,800 stimulus checks and who actually is going to receive them. That's the reason why, okay? So if you have any additional questions on that, please let me know down in the comment section below, and I'll address that in the next video. But let's get to the most pressing issues today. These are the most pressing issues for the American people and for Congress as well. Here's what we know. Right now, okay, and then I'll get to the human infrastructure bill in just a second, but there is something that's even more important than the human infrastructure bill, and that is the debt ceiling. That is the most pressing issue right now that faces U.S. people and the U.S. Congress. Here's what we know. Democrats are blaming Republicans. They're saying it's their debt. A lot of this debt came from former President Donald Trump. Well, yes, it did. It did, but it was also bipartisan bills that helped accumulate $8 trillion, right? It was both Republicans and Democrats that did this. Should Republicans step up and handle this? Probably, help out, Maybe. But Republicans are blaming Democrats, saying they have the power to do this on their own. They do not need Republican votes. And they have been stalling for the past 3 months while they try and pass their liberal wish list of items. Republicans also say that they told Democrats that if you do a budget reconciliation and push through that $1.9 trillion American Rescue Plan, it will be much harder to work with us in the future. Well, Republicans told Democrats exactly what was going to happen, and now they're sticking to their word. This was done, 9 months ago, 8 months ago, something like that? So yeah, it's nothing new. Democrats knew what was going to happen, and now Republicans are pretty much backing them into the corner. Well, Democrats also got a little bit of a heartbreak in another way. Senator Joe Manchin, who's a Democrat, is actually breaking with his fellow Democrats and saying that a budget reconciliation should not be off the table. This is something that Democrats should consider, because he goes on to say, and I quote, "We can prevent default. We really can prevent it, and there's a way to do that. And there's a couple other tools we have that we can use. Takes a little bit of time, it's gonna be a little bit of pain, long voteramas, a little, this is that, and what you have to do, but we cannot, and I want people to know, we will not let this country default." That was his statement. And when he was asked if Democrats should consider using a reconciliation process again, he said, "We'll do what we have to do, absolutely." So he's not saying the reconciliation bill is off the table for the debt ceiling increase or suspension. He's actually putting it back on there. When President Biden says that's not something that they're going to consider, that's something that multiple senators have said they do not have the time to do it. Well, again, it comes down to President Biden's Build Back Better plan, or his Build Back Better Act. Democrats only have one reconciliation left this year. One. However, the problem is they need the reconciliation for the Build Back Better plan, and they could potentially need a Build Back Better, or they need the reconciliation for the debt ceiling increase. They cannot do both unless they put the two together. But putting the two together and then also bringing in the $1.2 trillion infrastructure bill, again, they're trying to combine all these things. That's what's making it so difficult. That's the reason why we're seeing these bills take so long under a Democratic majority. With Republicans, a lot of times, what they would do, they wouldn't craft this huge bill and put it all together. They'd just get these small standalone bills and pass what they knew they could pass. And then they'd pretty much be like, "Oh, look at everything we got done." Democrats are like, "No, let's look at everything we could get done. Let's pass it." And that's why we're seeing all this fighting within the party. So we'll see what happens there. However, here's what we know. Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen said today that, yes, there is an option to actually mint a $1 trillion coin. It's still an option. However, she actually opposes this idea. And she says, and I quote, "I don't think we should be considering it seriously. It's really a gimmick. It compromises the independence of the Fed. And instead of showing that Congress and the administration can be trusted to pay the country's bills, it does the opposite. It's pretty much just a trick." Okay? It's pretty much just a trick. That's all it is. And she says we cannot trick the American people. We cannot trick the people that we owe money to. We can't do that. Now, it's an option. It will work. It will actually allow the government to stay funded. But the problem with that is it actually looks bad on our part. So she says, and she goes on to say that breaching the debt ceiling, even for a small time, okay, that she says this would cause a recession. Now, here's what I mean by just a small time. Because even though the debt ceiling can be increased, it doesn't have to be increased on or suspended on October 18th, which is technically our so-called X date, okay? So with that said, we could see Democrats push forward with the reconciliation. They could try to get the debt limit and the human infrastructure bill combined into one bill. That's a possibility. But the problem is they still have to negotiate the human infrastructure bill. They haven't done that yet. There's still a lot of questions there, and I'll get to that in just a minute. But right now, if they haven't addressed that issue, how do we add in the debt limit increase or a debt ceiling suspension? How do we do that? We can't. That's why things are taking a little bit longer. And according to Senator Dick Durbin, who's the number two Democrat in the Senate, he says that his experts are telling him that no, it's too late. And even though it is too late, even though going into or breaching the debt ceiling, even for a moment, would be bad, okay? Because it would delay a lot of bills, a lot of payments, okay? It would be bad, and it would most likely lead to a recession. The problem that we're facing now is, would it be better to be a little bit late, and then we'll raise the debt ceiling, you know, after 2 or 3 weeks into this pretty much default? Or would it be best to try to end the filibuster? Try to work with Republicans, right? And here's what I mean by working with Republicans. Right now, Republicans say that they are willing to negotiate the debt ceiling and the human infrastructure bill. That sounds good, right? That sounds really good. But here's the problem. Republicans, however, are trying to negotiate the two bills against each other, trying to negotiate the two things, okay? The human infrastructure bill, that's one. And then the debt ceiling increase, that's another. They're trying to negotiate the two together so only one actually succeeds. For instance, Senator Susan Collins, who's a Republican, she suggests that Republicans would back a debt limit hike if Democrats completely abandoned their quest for a $3.5 trillion social spending bill. She says multiple Republicans would actually support this idea. But then, this is where the talks stalled again. Democrats said that they will in no way stop pushing for a human infrastructure bill. They argued that the bulk of President Biden's Build Back Better Act is in this human infrastructure portion of the bill. So, as of this morning, this idea from Democrats is a non-starter. For Republicans, this is something that they would be willing to negotiate. Again, they're not saying they're gonna do it. They're gonna negotiate the idea because we do not know how high that debt ceiling hike would be. We don't know what the limit would be. That would be part of the negotiations. So this brings up the next question. What is going to be in the human infrastructure bill? When are we gonna see it? How much is it going to be? Let's address the first two questions, or the easiest questions. When are we gonna see it? Well, according to Chuck Schumer, he wants to see the plans of this on his desk this week. Well, we'll see if it happens. As for Speaker Nancy Pelosi, she actually says that she wants to see the bipartisan bill, the $1.2 trillion bill, passed within 26 days. Here's the problem, that we cannot see the $1.2 trillion bipartisan bill pass until after the human infrastructure bill has been agreed upon, okay? We, according to progressives, they say they need to see that the framework is acceptable, but others say that no, the bill has to pass. So that's kind of our timeline, possibly this week, possibly the end of this month. As to how much it's gonna be, experts are anticipating it's gonna be anywhere from $1.5 to probably $2.3 trillion. That's about where the size of this bill is gonna be. Now here's what we don't know. What's gonna be in it? Well, here's what I can tell you. Right now, according to Senator Bernie Sanders, he says, and he asked this on Twitter, he says, the vast majority of the American people want us to substantially lower prescription drug costs. Yes, obviously, too expensive. Expand Medicare to cover dental, vision, and hearing. Yes, that's something that is needed. Expand home health care. Yes, absolutely yes. Make childcare affordable. Again, absolutely yes. Lead the world in the fight against climate change. Yes, these are all things that the American people want. He says, let's get it done. But here's the question. The question remains, how do 50 senators agree to pass all these different pieces of legislation? How do they do that when so many of them still want their own agenda included as well? We don't see anything on there for free community college. We don't see anything on Senator Bernie Sanders' list. This was over on Twitter. You can go and check it out. This is under his Bernie Sanders account, not Senator Sanders. And there's nothing on here for extending the child tax credit payments. Nothing there, right? So these are just different things. There's nothing for college, right? That was a big one. Pre-K. There's nothing for preschool or pre-kindergarten. It's not on there. But on top of how do you get all 50 Senate Democrats to agree, is there even enough money to make all these things happen? Most people say no, that there's not enough money. That creates another issue. So what I can tell you right now is that the goal for this week and next week, according to multiple reports, is just to figure out how much is the bill going to be? What is the top line number? In order to figure out the top line number, they have to figure out what piece of legislation are they going to include? Because if they can determine that and they extend it out for 10 years, they'll be able to come up with a top line number based off of that. And then all they have to do, and again, it's very simple. Let's say it takes, 10 years of, $350 billion per year, right? $3.5 trillion. That's exactly what it is now. Well, what if instead of $3.5 trillion, all they're trying to do is get to, $1.4 trillion or $1.75, right? Okay, simple math. Here's what we know. It takes $350 billion per year. So you got $350 billion on year one, you got $700 billion on year two, you got $1.5 trillion or $50 billion on year three, you got $1.4 trillion on year four, and you got $1.75 trillion on year five, okay? So we could get to essentially $2.1 trillion, and it would cover 6 years. 6 years at $2.1 trillion. So instead of going 10 years, all they do is just cut it down. Like I mentioned, with the $1,500 and $1,800 child tax credit payments, that's not what they're doing. They're not cutting down the overall size. They're just shrinking the scope. Instead of going 10 years, they're just gonna go maybe five. That's the discussions as of right now. So it makes it very easy once they know the provisions that are gonna be within the bill, how to make it fit within the top line numbers. And if it's $1.5 trillion, then so be it. They'll adjust it from there. But that's one of the big questions. But now let's get into some COVID news for today. We actually got some good news, some bad news, some good news. Studies have now proven that Pfizer vaccine's efficacy rate drops from 88% down to just 47% after 6 months of the second dose. The data suggests that the drop is due to the waning efficacy, not due to a more contagious variant. Okay. So that is good news, that it's not because the variants are more contagious, it's because the efficacy rate is actually waning off the longer that you wait after getting the second dose. The study also shows that the vaccine's effectiveness against Delta was 93% within the first month. That's pretty good. But it quickly declined to just 53% after just 4 months. This is why the expectations coming from many health experts is that Americans are on the verge of getting the approval for another booster shot. This is gonna come from, or go to many people. A lot of it's gonna be teachers, first responder, anybody on the front lines is gonna be able to get this. And then obviously the next age group will be included as well. So this is gonna be really good. If you've already received your vaccine, the booster shot is expected to help. Just understand, if you saw some complications or you saw some side effects from the second dose of the Pfizer vaccine the last time you took it, just understand you are most likely going to see the exact same side effects this time around, okay? Just plan on that. Also, Johnson & Johnson has asked the FDA for approval of their booster shot today. Now, they didn't provide any guidance as to who should receive their booster shots first, but they said they're gonna leave that up to the FDA and the CDC. We also know, according to Dr. Scott Gottlieb, he says that he thinks that this Delta wave that we are currently in will be the last major surge of COVID here in the US. Here in the US. I wanna make sure that's 100% clear. We do not know about other countries, but here in the US, he says this could be the last major surge. He also believes that around Thanksgiving, we will see the levels nationally start to decline and head back to a more manageable level. This is gonna be after Thanksgiving, most likely before the first of the year. So we're gonna see what happens there, but as always, as I know more, I promise I'll come back on and share all the latest news and updates. I just wanna provide you with this information. If you have any questions whatsoever, please ask your questions down in the comment section below. Again, thank you guys for watching, consider subscribing, and I'll see you guys on the next one.